Greetings and welcome to episode 59 of my Empire Total War Darth Mod USA campaign. And this, my friends, how we left it last time, where we had a tremendous fight, my friends, a huge, huge, brutal fight here in Konigsberg. One that we did not expect at all. It really did come out of left field with the Germans or the Prussians, my friends, sending an army here, which sort of on the border here in Poland, moving across here, sort of laterally across here, attacking us, moving us from south sort of to north to the west here, and attacking this defending army here under the General Will Broly here, absolutely coming along here and absolutely trying to drag us in as well here. Anthony Morris, of course, General Morris as well, staunch defender as well of Konigsberg, but trying to pull us into, draw us in from a fight from this one angle here, and then drawing in all of the sort of defending forces at Gdansk. But my friends, we absolutely gave them the thrashing of their lives. They lost nearly 15,000 men in that assault, in that attack. We lost 4,000 men, and I say only 4,000 men, but that's a grievous loss for us all. Every single loss we made there has to be acknowledged for their bravery, my friends, their valour, their discipline in battle. And they really did prove themselves invaluable in this fight in the defence of Konigsberg. It really was a stupendous, stupendous defence, and one that we can all be proud of. All troops, all generals can be absolutely proud of their men here, my friends, all who fought in. Look at this. General Friedland's army was absolutely hammered to pieces, but they held their position. They did not yield one inch. And because of that, we've opened up some breathing space for us. Not a lot of breathing space, because you can see Germany is instantaneously reinforcing Gdansk here, because they're just a little bit wary of us. Because, as you remember, we have these four reinforcing armies here brought in from Hanover that will be evacuated, and we still do not leave any man behind on the battlefield, and that includes here the General Baker here and his army. Now, many of you I know are saying, take Berlin if you can. Now, this really is a difficult choice for me to make, and your advice has been absolutely exemplary. It really, as always, your advice is incredible. It really is. And many of you, I'm going to take all your advice on this, particularly of the Mughal Empire. We'll get to those in a moment. Now, some of you are saying go for Berlin, some of you are saying evacuate General Baker and put his army to good use elsewhere. I'm probably going to go for the latter, my friends. Berlin might be a little bit out of our reach here because we've only got one army. It's not a full stack army, not because I don't have any confidence in General Baker and his men. I do, but it's just that we may not have enough forces here to push and take Berlin, especially what they've got around here. As you can see, they've even got this army here moving in our direction towards the east here. We're also surrounded by quite potent armies around here. So I throw them into Berlin, I'm going to lose not only a good general but a good army as well. I'd rather reinforce this army and make it into a really powerful shock force that can be of use to us in Warsaw and in Konigsberg. And my friends, I must reveal to you right now that we are looking possibly to move into Russia quite soon. Now, the reason to move into Russia is this. As you can see here, we've got these forces here loitering around here. Look at that. That's a pretty potent force right there. Jaeger, Guard Jaegers. Look at that range. Look at that accuracy. It's incredible there. Superior Line Infantry, Prussian Jaeger. They've got some pretty potent forces. Conscripts, okay, we could ignore those, but they've got some pretty powerful forces here. And where are they coming from? Here. Minsk, Belarus. It's absolutely going to be a thorn in our side. Now, we can't obviously attack Russia directly. They would draw in quite a powerful enemy here, and as you can see, they're giving Sweden an absolute thrashing here. If Sweden falls, Russia will become an exponential threat to us. It really will become a really grave threat to us. We have to cover our back. We have to eliminate the assets that we can reach, that we can reach in Russia. Now, we can't attack Russia because we're not strong enough yet. We are pretty, you know, pretty snarled up here within the fight here, within the fences of Germany. But what we can do is, if we take Poland, Warsaw, this opening here, look at this, we can move through here, we can move through Lubin, we can use it as a staging post, and we can build up, maybe send in an army group into Minsk. Now, what we will do is be sending in our spy here to get that intelligence, get that military intelligence. We need to find out what's happening in Minsk. If Minsk is weakly defended, then we can eventually, not right now, because we've got a lot on our plate at the moment. We've got a lot of things to sort out here, a lot of things to deal with Germany. But in the future, we are going to be looking at moving into sort of what was Russian territory, which is now German territory, but it's still within Russia here. Now, if we can look at the size of Minsk, I mean, it is absolutely huge. Look at the potential here for the economic as well. They've got a steam-powered cloth mill. They've got a pleasure gardens, the classical university, which can be turned into economics. We've got all our research full here. We've got the pleasure gardens here. So one of these will become an economic powerhouse. We've got the Minsk itself. We've got a farmland, palatial estates. We've even got another palatial estates down here. It's huge, but it also puts us in within touching distance of two vitally strategic points here within Russia, Kiev and Moscow. Now, of course, these really are the absolute linchpin of Russian dominance here in this sort of east. But also, it also puts us... We can't move through French territory. Maybe if we get some kind of alliance, maybe if we get some military access. But again, they're sort of southern assets down here, where they've been fighting a pretty brutal war, to be honest, with the Ottomans. And it looks like the Ottomans have actually taken Bulgaria back, if I'm not mistaken. That could actually be pretty useful for us, because that means that we are drawing a huge amount of forces away from the Ottoman frontier, which might actually aid the Ottomans in pushing back against the Germans here. But mind you, we do have Austria as well at war, so we've got to keep an eye on that. But still, our assets have to be used. So Minsk is definitely going to be a future target, but not yet. We have other things to deal with at the moment, i.e. Warsaw, which we really need to get get our hands on really, really quickly. So again, we've sent in General Larsen, the hammer, my friends, to absolutely kick in the door here of Warsaw, take this region off them. And then we're going to have to really sort of hunker down here, try and get peace with them. If we can't get peace, we're going to have to reinforce pretty quickly here. We'll probably do by doing that by sending also General Baker back and moving some of these forces that come from Hanover around here to try and push them away here. We've also at war with the Mughal Empire. For some reason, they've declared war on us. Not a clue why. Don't know why they did that. But obviously, they've done it. It's done, my friends. We do not ever back down from any enemy at all. We do not shirk at all. We stand tall, my friends. And Afghanistan is absolutely booming here. I mean, look at this. But they've given Kashmir to Naples and Sicily. I wonder if they've traded that for somewhere else, because Naples and Sicily wouldn't give up too much other land unless there was some sort of benefit to them. Now, many of you are saying, take Ceylon with the armies that have arrived. Let's get to the edge of the map here. That have arrived here from Brazil. We've got two very potent armies here. Look at that, my friends. What a beautiful army. It's got two militia regiments in there, or three even. And we've got another army here, not full. And we've also got an agent on board here, which will definitely be useful, I think, for scouting Mughal. So I'm going to take your advice. Many of you have been saying, take Ceylon with these two armies. We are going to take it. We're going to move and use Ceylon as a forward operating base here. Let me take your advice. It'll set us up for future campaigns. It might even draw some of the Mughal forces into Ceylon for a battle, moving their gaze from elsewhere. Let's do this. Let's send ourselves here. We're going to India, my friends. Gentlemen, please. And India here. Look at that. We're on our way to India. The Mughals thought they could just ride roughshod over us. Wrong. No one does that. Nobody. And also, many of you are saying, I need to build some more ships and send some fleets here to blockade all of these ports here, the Mughals. I beg your pardon, I keep saying Ottomans. I don't know why I've got that in my brain. We are going to blockade these ports here. It really would crush them economically if we were to really put that under a lot of pressure. That a port there as well, it is Calcutta. They are very, very well dug in here. It would be an absolute brutal war if we were to invade India. And I don't think we've got enough troops just yet, because look at that. Not only their quality isn't brilliant, but it's the sheer amount of troops they can throw at us is the main problem we would have. A lot of bowmen here. And also, many of you have got very keen eyes as well. They did send out a fleet. Now, I believe the fleet came from the Portia St. John's, Portia in Newfoundland. I believe it's probably around this area here. We are going to search for it. And also, many of you saying, remove the Mughal from the northwest up here. Remove them from America, from sort of the Canadian peninsula, as it were, here. Get rid of them in Agvetuk, get rid of them in Newfoundland. Actually, Newfoundland would be a pretty good forward staging base here. We'd be pretty close then to the European route here, the European theatre. Britain has obviously joined the war with the Mughals, but I think we're going to close this port down here. And this one here. Are they building there? No, but if we can get these, it would be excellent for us. So I think the first thing we need to do, the first order of business, is to find that Mughal fleet. We don't want any of these towns to be taken here, or any of these cities. Right, let's have a quick look around here, shall we? Let's see what we can find. Come on, show yourselves. Oh! There it is, my friends. Let's have a look here, what they got. Well, they got one first rate. They've got two first rates, beg your pardon. They've got a second ship of the line, three first rates. The rest are fourths. Some frigates, they'd be quite pretty quick. Let's have a look at the army. What? The army's all bowmen and levy mob. One musketman natives. I can absolutely guarantee you they would aim straight for Virginia. And they would probably take it because there's nothing guarding there, and even Maryland would be under quite a lot of pressure here from that. Even from that sort of, not a brilliant army, but it would take a city pretty quickly because we've got no defence here at all. I do worry about that defence. Let's get these up and running here, my friends, because we are going to start getting ourselves back here. Economics, we're going to push everything. We might be in our best interest to actually put a force together here in the Carolinas that can be used to cover Virginia and Maryland. So with that in mind, we're going to recruit troops from here, from Florida. And we've also got this force here that's been sat here for a while. I think we'll have them stationed in Maryland here and build an army that's going to take care of itself. We've got to be self-sufficient. We don't want to be relying on... Okay, we're going to do that for the moment. Ooh, look at that there. And they can also be sent down to Maryland as well. That's excellent. We've already got a self-made army there. We're going to rid ourselves of these fiends here. Of course, look at that. What a wonderful sight. It looks like they're moving back here. I think we're going to chase them down. Where are they? Ah! That's a lot more potent. We're going to detach these two here and send them forth. And these are going to move to here. If that fleet wants to come and attack us, then fair it can do. But we've got these armies moving into position. We can actually cover it with the army in Philadelphia as well. So actually Virginia and that isn't too bad. Plus one here. I think we need to build some more ships. I think many of you said get another fleet up and running. So I'm going to do. We've got a lot of these to improve as well, which we have neglected because of our fighting in Europe, which really has dominated a lot of our assets, our resources. So let's recruit. I think, can we get any more? Maybe we'll have two of those. Let's get some faster ships as well. Any brig, rocket ship, sixth rate. I think we'll have some frigates just for their speed. Let's mix up the fleets a little bit here. I think we're okay here in the US. I think the US is pretty secure. We're going to have to use some of the armies in the US here to actually, I think, take Newfoundland and move these gentlemen into position. We're going to attack Agvetuk. What the blazes is going on here? We've upgraded that. That's an absolute scandal we haven't done that. We've lost all of that money there for not doing that. 1,200. But we've done it now. So we're going to move forces into position. We're going to take Pleasancy or Plaisance here, Newfoundland. Actually, that'll come in very useful for us. And we're also going to take Agvertuk here and cut off any more pressure coming from the Mughal. If they want to send it, they have to send it from India. But our next goal, our next task, my friends, is to absolutely hammer home here against Warsaw and the garrison here. Now, the garrison isn't massive here. Wait a minute, they've got no garrison. They've got no garrison. Okay, what we need to do here is just move this gentleman a little bit closer. So we've got everything in support here. Can move. And he only brings in a few forces here. Don't tell me they're going to surrender. Don't tell me they're going to surrender. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. They're going to surrender. We've brought 10, we've brought 13,000 men to this fight. Up against just over 4,000 men. Will they surrender? Come on, gentlemen. Oh, they've done it. They've surrendered. That is unbelievable. Unbelievable. After all we've done for Warsaw and they've just surrendered. Right, the first thing we've got to do here is secure Warsaw as quickly as possible. Immediately. Get men across this river as quickly as possible here. Oh my word, that is absolutely exceptional work. Oh, Alexander, once again, General Alexander's absolutely plowed through, but we've got a... Even if we exempt them from tax, that's what we have to do that, I think. Food shortages are going to come to an end. Devastation by armies. So we're going to take care of... Taking the tax off, we don't need the tax for this because we've got all we've got coming in, 37,000. Oh my word, that is exceptional. Good grief, look at the armies they got here. Nothing to be sniffed at all. I wonder now if we've secured Warsaw, can we actually get peace here? And the thing we must do is not forget General Broly here at all. We're not going to forget him. Bravery is an example to all. We're not going to lose him for my own neglect. Safe. One thing we do is look after our men here. Those that have given much to the cause. Any orders? Now, this is army replenishing here. I can only hope it is. Indeed it is. It's taken a real battering, this army here. So we're going to move them to here. Because Courland are not happy with us at all. And actually, General Broly and his army here can actually secure this sort of northern flank here. There's quite a bit of lag there from that. But that's taking Warsaw without even a fight. That is absolutely incredible for us. Where can we reinforce? I think we'll just move the fleet into here. We've got these two ships available to us. And we'll leave these two ships here. But we can bring these armies now that took the fight last time. We're going to bring them up. Actually, they're being replenished already, which is wonderful to see. Now, oh, look at that, that arm, that there is going to be repaired. Now, oh, army of... General Friedland fought wonderfully there. 5,000 worth every single gold piece. Look at that there. What a fight that was. And actually, the army of General Morris just 392, so I believe that was this regiment here that came in to support. That's being replenished. Now, Sam General Allen here. The 2nd New York, my friends, what can you say about the 2nd New York? They killed over 500 of the enemy. The single highest kill count for any regiment in that fight. Look at the reg, look at the... Replenish. Yes. Goodwin, Dexter, oh my word. General Bowley, the army took an absolute thrashing there, but they fought with absolute valour. And finally, the army of General Ursoy again fighting with valour. Friends, take a phone call there. So I believe General Ursoy here's the forces that came in fought valiantly here, but look at that, we have absolutely thrashed the Germans here. We've taken Warsaw, which is an absolute boon for us. It really is. What a wonderful sight. And we can begin to recruit as well pretty aggressively now. We're at war with a lot of force of nations here. Can we now try and get peace with Germany? Let's try. My God, they don't like us at all, but can we get peace? Let's just try a basic peace. They're thinking about it. They're considering it. They're considering it. That's a lot of debate they've got there. Actually got peace. What? Wow. That was pretty exceptional. I don't like that there though. But my word, that was very much needed there by us. We've actually got peace. Oh, that classical university. Destroyed. We can now whoa, ho, ho, ho. They've actually moved here because they're allied with France. They can actually move into Galicia here in Podolia. They also move forces back to Gdansk, Minsk, Belarus. I think now we can start rearranging our troops. Could we Dexter from where? He must have ordered, of course. Must have had an army inside there. Poland. Oh, we've got to look at that. That's a wonderful sight, my friends. We've now solidified our hold here. Okay, now we can start to push out. We can rearrange some of these armies now, bringing them into a better tactical position for us. We haven't now, these forces here, these naval forces here, aren't needed now to hold down these ports still, but we're going to keep them in place. We're not going to allow anything to slip our grasp here at all. Now, if that means that Prussia can now start opening up its trade again, which means they'll increase their strength from the finances they've got, but still, it was a necessary evil. Ankara and Atalia here look more and more inviting to us here, and so does the Knights of St. John. Now, we've got peace here. We can't be doing anything else. We can't trade because obviously they're blocked, they're full here. We're friendly with the Ottomans again. our ports are full to capacity. We have to try and upgrade our ports, but we need to organize ourselves a bit better here at the moment. Things look a little bit shambolic here. We're gonna have to solidify the hold here. We've got threats coming from Galatian Podolia here. Whoa ho ho ho. What are you doing there, my friend? So we're gonna have to rearrange this here. We're gonna have to cover, probably putting forces across the road here that lead to Lublin. And probably Lodz as well. We want to surround Warsaw like we have here with Königsberg. I think we have to move forces as well to cover the gap here between the forest here, between East Prussia and Poland. A pleasure garden which is holding down that firm there. I think we might make that into a pleasure garden to make it a bit more manageable to control the populace. We're going to get a rebellion for definite. Alright, these armies are going to stay where they are. The army here of General Tomalin, that can be reinforced now. We need more than that. We need cannon. That's more like it. Our General Hoover here. I think we should begin to move them into the forest here to guard this sort of corridor between East Prussia and Poland. I'm going to start moving these army groups up. We have here Robert General Catton. And again, we're going to move this general to here and his army here. Keeping that close coordination between the armies. We're not going to have massive gaps between them. Everything must remain here. General Cobb. Again, we can move General Cobb here to fill the corridor between the two. Had a gap, a perfect gap there. And we've got General Beckham, one of the staunch defender, an excellent general. I think we're going to move General Beckham to cover the Vilnius frontier and the Russian front. Move him right up to the border here. And we're going to have General Broly, or General Baker, I beg your pardon, in support. And also we're going to have John Waxer, remember? Valiant fight to cover the border here. And now we can move these, we can swing these armies around. We haven't got a general here, so you will see very soon, my friends, that there will be a general, a new general appointed here. Anybody who wants this this army under your control and your command, please, my friends, put your in the comments. I will bring a new general into this campaign. You will be fighting in Europe. Remember, if you want to fight in the Americas, you will may have to wait. If you want to fight in Europe and really sort of help carve out this European empire that we are striving for, then please put your name in the comments, my friends. I will choose a new general for this army here. It is currently vacant, but remember, you will be fighting in the brutal campaign on in Europe. It will not be easy, so only the strong-willed need apply. Sir, we have here General S4, who's been an absolute staunch defender here of Königsberg. I think we might form here a reserve army group here on the border between Königsberg. We don't leave too much exposed here. We will do. We've got General Tomalin here. We're going to move General Tomlin to here, which will complete the surrounding here of Königsberg and secure it. But I think we're going to move General S4 to the forests here. And also the army waiting for its general. We're going to form a reserve here in the forests. It's a pity we can't hide. And also in the fort, General Mendoza, who's been absolutely staunch, look at that, staunch defender here of the sort of the rear of Königsberg. And again, we're going to use... pull that out here. We're going to form this reserve army group here in the forests between Poland and East Prussia. Oh my word, I can't... it's such a great feeling to have this locked down and secure. I think we need to secure Warsaw across the river here. So we're going to move General Burgess across the river. General Boehm, again, just to cover this sort of northeastern flank. Ideally, we want to cross. I think what we're going to have to do is move these armies around. Now, gentlemen, please. That's more like it. General Donaldson. And last but by no means least, Dominic Zeno. Actually, we're going to keep that connection between these armies quite closely. Look at that, my friends. What a beautiful looking sight there that is. And I think we can also start recruiting in here as well. Look at that, 24 pounders. Get some of these already. You're starting to recruit here. We really have pushed our economy. We've also gained here by taking Warsaw. We've also got this peace treaty here with Prussia. But how long that will last, we don't know. It might prove fruitful for us, but by damn, we've had to fight our way through just to get where we are right now. But look at that, we've got our enclave here in the east of Europe here, bordering Russia. We've got some excellent generals here guarding this flank here into East Prussia. We've also got a reserve force here, but we need to take care now of the Mughal Empire. That's going to be our next task. Make sure we've got everything here. That's being dismantled. I think we've got, let's double check we've got everything here. That's being mass production here, which will bring down the recruit of all of these, which would be fantastic. We've got everything here. Yep, we've done the right decision. Okay. And we're moving to Ceylon as well. We're going to take Ceylon as a forward operating base for future operations in India. Anyone else we can... look at that in front of you. Can we trade with them, I wonder? No, I've got to watch Courland. Hostile. Wonder. Always indifferent. Can we get a trade agreement with them? Let's just send something their way where they've got everything. Fair enough. Greece. I wonder if Greece would change its mind. No, what if we were to... no, they've got everything as well. Barbary States, Afghanistan. Wow, that reminds me. Ah. There it is. Afghanistan. Afghanistan, I've got Upper Louisiana. What is going on there? And of course, we've got still got the Plains Nations here, but looks like they're taking attrition from something. That's going to be a tough army to try and remove there. We've got our spy in position in case anything moves on that front. I think we've got every... oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute, gentlemen. We have to put another army here. I think you're from Mexico. And that's going to be sent probably up to here as well. We're going to detach to move these to here. And this force is going to guard this front here. But we can take care of the Mughal Empire if it starts anything with us. Look at our trade here. We're getting hit here by the Mamluks and Persia being completely cut off or being traded. Ministers, oh look at that, 75% popularity. Justice is not brilliant. That, look, oh, many of you said get rid of this gentleman here. And I think we're going to do that. Yes, that's more like it. And justice is not brilliant either. If we can get one of these, look at these. If only we could move these gentlemen in, but we can't. We can't kick him yet, but we will be kicking this gentleman as well. Yeah, the Vice President wasn't good at all. Right, let's end the tour, my friends. Enough talking, let's get on with this. Britain. France. Looks like Britain's been chasing down France. I told you, that's a brutal fight there against France and Britain. It really is. Consuming a huge amount. Oh, well done, Britain. Well done. Well done, good sir. Well done. That is fantastic to see. Absolutely fantastic to see. Whoa, that isn't. If you come for us, Austria, we should be prepared. We are prepared for you now. There's France. Hang on a minute. Why are they in Berlin? What's Prussia going to do? Nothing silly Prussia at all. Looks like they're going to reposition their forces here. They're still moving forces up here to Gdansk. Now they're starting to reinforce every single region they have here to make sure that if war breaks out again, every region is secure, which is a viable tactic here, but it doesn't make life easy for us. But we do have the forces here to probably break through, but Gdansk is still being reinforced, and now obviously their fleets are free now to move as they see fit. So I think we're going to have to reinforce our fleets in Europe here. We cannot take our eye off Königsberg at all, because they are reinforcing Gdansk here. That is slightly unnerving. Just pull away from the border there. I think we might push up an army here just to move them away from here. That's right, they're moving back now into Minsk, and they're moving down into Podolia, is it, I think. That's good, they're moving away from those fronts there. Naples and Sicily. Look at there, look at those fiends. I knew they would go for it. I knew they would go for that. But we have these forces in position here, and if I'm not mistaken, they've got a lot of troops here though. And these gentlemen here, not going to really be able to take that force on there until those reinforcements come in, but we've got an excellent army here in reserve, which should be good enough to take these on. But we're going to have to pull right back with these gentlemen and wait for these to move in. What have we got coming in here? I think we've got more than enough here to take this, but I knew they would move from Maryland, and we didn't destroy that fleet last time, so it's going to cause a problem here for us. But I think, my friends, we're going to take this fight. We are not going to allow the Mughal here to do what they want. They're not going to be taking Maryland from us. Just as well we've got armies in situ here to deal with such a threat. But Maryland always seems to be the sort of the main goal for these forces here. If we could push them out from that port, destroy that fleet. Britain has pretty much closed down the Mughal assets in Newfoundland and Aquitaine, which means they won't be raiding us anymore. So once this army has been eliminated, we can then take the fight to the Mughal, taking Ceylon. I'll be damned if we're going to be pushed around by anybody else I can assure you, my friends, we will not be pushed around by any nation at all. As was proven by Prussia, Prussia attacked us at the beginning. They took advantage of our war with Spain and with Britain to try and take territories, and they've paid the price. Right in the slap bang in the middle of this village here. So what we're going to do is we're going to use this to our advantage. We're going to use this to break them up here. So they have to come and fight us. That's going to give us time for our other armies to come in. So we're just going to just put them into a general thus, and we can just wait. Right, they're all over. Good grief. Excellent, excellent. That means we can probably attack them from this. Oh dear. Right, first things first, let's get ourselves organized here. I'm going to cover this road here. Oh, look at that, what a beautiful sight. Gentlemen, please. Let's get these set up here on the right. Gonna use the open front we got here. Double time, gentlemen, double time. We've got General Han here moving in. Beautiful. We've got our cavalry. Get the left flank covered as well. Got plenty of cavalry coming in here. We're going to absolutely pound these pieces with our cavalry. We're not going to have any slackers here. One thing I can't stand is laziness. We need time for any lazy people in our army. Could indeed even send out a strike force here to deal with. I don't think they've got anything that can really threaten us here. They're trying to move in some bowmen, but it's going to give us time to get ourselves well set up here. I think we'll send an advance party of light infantry here. Oh, look at the guns we got here, my friends. It's beautiful to see. Hey, gentlemen. And Limber, they'll be brought in. I think what we can do is begin to look to raid this flank here. And we can pull these gentlemen away from here. They can actually, can they go up here? No, yes they can actually. Gentlemen, this is not a Sunday stroll. Oh my goodness me, this is unbelievable. Are we actually watching you just kneel? Oh my word, look at that. What an absolutely wonderful sight to see. Gentlemen, please. Down on these levy here. Levy, should I say. Gonna put them on skirmish. Look at this. Let's get into these levy here. Gotta disrupt, we've gotta disrupt as much as we can here. Oh my gosh, what an absolute wonderful sight. The power of the art of the cannon, my friend. Look at that. Did they really think they would just merely move into our lands here and try and take Maryland off us? I don't think so, sir. I don't think so. I knew they would try and move through here. It's a wonderful sight. Look at that, they're bunched up beautifully there. Let's maybe get a lucky hit on that general there. If we can take that general out there, it would be a wonderful sight. Come on, get those cannons firing. Come on. That's a lot of forces right there. Come on, gentlemen, come on now. Oh, what a beautiful shot. Look at that. Ooh, another cannon. That will definitely come in useful. Thank you very much, good sir. I think we can pull these gentlemen into reserve. There's no need to be using men that are not needed. Get out of there, gentlemen. Get out of there. Light infantry mode, if you would please, gentlemen. Thank you. Oh, look at that, that's an absolute death from above. Look at that. Maybe this will push the Mughals into the peace table. Maybe they'll send them to the peace table. Who knows? I'll be damned if we're going to be pushed around by anybody ever again. Oh, now we're going to start to bombard these. A lot of troops there. Let's put those Levy under a lot of pressure. really is a wonderful sight to see. Steady lads, steady now. Come on, get that fire on here. And Limber. Right across the bow. Really is a wonderful sight to see. Look at this, they've been absolutely smashed to smithereens here. Did they really think they would just meander into Maryland here and take it from us? I don't think so, sir. Oh, look at that, even better. Additional reinforcements. Take your time, gentlemen. Take your time. General Han, you've performed excellently well here, sir. Be firing at will, you will be. Pull these gentlemen out of here. Look at that. It would appear. General moving in here with the elephants. What if we could hit these elephants? These are the real backbone of the army here. It's a magnificent sight, but look at the field of death here, look at it. We've absolutely obliterated them. Cleared this entire flank here. I think now we can probably push on here. More time, gentlemen. Double time! Fire when ready. Oh, look at this. It's a wonderful sight to watch. Changing those targets. utter obliteration. Can we now swing these regiments around? Close the gate here. Just move these regiments into place. Make sure that we are protecting our artillery. What did they expect would happen? Extend your range, please, gentlemen. Extend your range. Coming to these shores was your wisest move. And you will pay, just like all others who have dared to set foot upon US territory without permission, have suffered the same fate. I think we can probably push in here as well. From behind. Double time, gentlemen, double time. Guns fall silent. Well, lads, move up. Chase them down. Before they move out of the way here. Come on, gentlemen, please. general down. I'd take this general down. Reload! That was a beautiful sight. Pop! Pop! Yes. And so ends the first foray of the Mughal Empire into our domain here. And now they know what they will face if they do it again. Look at that. They lost 6,000. We lost 453 men. We killed 6,000. You move away from there, fiend. Afghanistan. That was a beautiful fight. Ottomans, okay. Russia, nothing silly from you, Russia. Ooh, looks like Russia is pushing really hard against Sweden now. Could we see the collapse of Sweden? We're at war with them, so it doesn't matter to us. But what happens is, if Russia takes Sweden Swedish territory, that is going to give them a huge amount of economic power here. Persia, Spain. Sweden reinforcing. Obviously not wanting to lose. Ooh, look at that. Well, Sweden, you wanted a war with us. You've got it. Courland. Yeah, reading those trade lines there. Mamluks. I haven't really seen much from the Mamluks, Greece, Norway. I like it. It's ready to go. It's ready to go. What have we got here? 23,000. Why is that? Ah. Great Britain's been hit once again by the Barbary States. We've also got a couple of raids going on here. 131,000 our tax income. Trade has been hit pretty hard there. I thought so. That's going to be brought under control pretty rapidly there. Much quicker than I thought. We've got a lot of troops being built here as well. Onward. I'm going to send him into the army here of Will Broly. Can we recruit? Almost got those recruited there. All of these almost replenished here. Some of these are taking a real hit here, but look at that. We have to secure probably this end here from Lublin to Warsaw. We do have good forces here. Move this army here, the army of General Cobb, to there. Just to sort of fill that hole in there between that line there. It's been a very hard-fought campaign there. What else do we have here? Excellent. I think what we will do is we're going to send forces in just to examine what's been going on here. My word, look at that. They've got a heck of a lot of forces still around. Thank you. was very silly. That was extremely, extremely silly. I had them all selected. That was very, very silly of me there. I've wasted a huge amount of money. I think we'll have... because I selected all the units. Idiot, Mallet, idiot. They're under repair there, thankfully. And these definitely need to be repaired and replenished. These need to be moved out of there. Prepare for war, sir. Out, and we're going to crush this fleet. The British have taken care of that for us, which is excellent. We are going to crush this fleet here. We shall get these being back to port to replenish. Oh, we'll take the money from that. Replenish and repair that. Orders. They will remain there. These will move back to here. These gentlemen will be taken care of. They will be dealt with. Yes, sir. Leg ready. I think, my friends, I think we have pretty much solidified our hold here. We are going to take care of Akvatuk. General Ahmed, and we've got another general here. It's going to be needed to be taken up, my friends. We have another army available here in America. They will be fighting against the Mughal Empire here. So if anyone else would like to have this taken command of this army fighting in North America, then please, my friends, let me know. Excellent. Anything else need to be upgraded here? I don't believe so. Gotta take care of this army. We don't want them harassing us too much. But we need to keep our focus as well as best we can. What we are going to do is recruit extensively here. See where that takes us. What do we need in this army? Let's get a good composition. We've got three guns. We definitely need infantry, so we're going to go quite infantry heavy here. Excellent. And my friends, I think we're going to leave this episode right there. We've had quite an eventful episode. We're waiting for those two armies there, those two fleets to arrive from Madagascar. We're going to be hitting Ceylon, ready for that forward operating base in India. We have thrashed that Indian or Mughal force that landed and went for Maryland. We've secured Warsaw without even a shot being fired, and soon the populace will soon be brought under control as well by garrison forces. Probably a crackdown would probably not go too far either, but we brought them under control quite quickly. If we exempt them from attacks, what would our tax then be? 33,000, but we don't do that just yet. We are going to bring them under control here, populace. Well, actually, I did say I would turn this here. I'm going to turn that into a pleasure garden. I'm going to go coaching in. And that, my friends, is an excellent, excellent, excellent campaign thus far of 1819. We're in the winter at the moment. It was brutally cold here on the Eastern Front, but we have done absolutely fantastically well. We really have. I'm proud of each and every man here who fought on the Eastern Front. We've got peace as well with Prussia or Germany. We're still at war with Austria, Spain. I went to war with the Mughal. My word, my friends, we're at war with, and also with Sweden, but Sweden's getting absolutely destroyed by the Russians at the moment. There's a good chance that our bow here in Finland might fall very quick. Look at that army there the Russians have sent in. That is pretty formidable. And they've got quite a strong force here up around St. Petersburg and Riga. We've secured our lands, we've secured the gap here between Warsaw and Königsberg, we've secured the rear here, just in case Russia ever decides they want to try and move in on us here. But look at their forces, they've arrayed here. And again, we've surrounded Warsaw here to guard that. We've also got a reserve force here in East Prussia. Let me know if I should leave this here, or should I send it somewhere else. We've also got, oh, look at that, we have moved General Baker's army. Should be moved into position. I do beg your pardon. Look at that. Now that solidified that flank there. But my friends, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, please comment, like, and subscribe. And as always, my friends, please keep your comments coming down below. They've been absolutely fantastic. Your comments, everything has been wonderful. You've helped me shape this campaign, and in particular this episode as well. I'm taking your advice with what taking peace with Warsaw Germany, which we take Warsaw, which we've done. I'm moving forces now to go and take Ceylon, which again you recommended, my friends. You've also said to go and take Newfoundland and Akvituk. We've already assembling forces to go and do that. So, and Britain is blockading the ports for us. So everything is going really, really smoothly at the moment. It's taken a long time to get where we are at the moment. It's cost a lot of lives on both sides, particularly ours. And we've invested hundreds of thousands of gold into this campaign, literally hundreds of thousands, to try and build the armies and to maintain our European holdings here. We've got 21,000 coming in. If we were to open up the Warsaw, if we opened up Warsaw to tax, that would actually boost our income. Look at that, to 33,000. So we a massive jump there from that tax income. Look at that tax income. It would a massive jump there. Look at that. What's that, 12,000 jump in tax income? Massive. We're going to just exempt them for a while till we get under control. We get a coaching in the pleasure gardens up and running here, and that will really help us maintain control over the populace here. We'll probably need to boost our presence here in Poland. It's not really that strong at the moment. So if they attack us again, we don't want to be losing Warsaw immediately. So we'll probably use this reserve army group, probably to move it into this area here. Give us that extra presence in here. But my word, my friends, it's been an absolute tough fight here. But I salute every single one of you. All of you have been involved in this campaign, whether you fought directly on the European front, whether you fought in the American front. We've got a long way to go, my friends, before we achieve what we set out to be, and that is to have an empire here in Europe that stretches all the way from the Atlantic all the way right across, my friends, right across here, the Arctic Ocean. Everything will be under our control, but it's going to take a long, long time. We've got a lot of battles ahead of us and a lot of planning, a lot of tactics, a lot of strategic thinking has got to go into this. A huge investment again. I know we're going to have a massive investment because, you know, Germany equals us, you know, quite easily here on this, because of course we are indeed on their sort of, they are in their homeland, as it were. And so they really do have, hang on a minute, they've, looks like that France have given them one of the lands I gave France. Was it Saxony? Wow. But we've got, and we're also still at war with Austria as well, so we've got a huge amount. Austria are not too far across the border here. They are actually in Poland, right on the edge here of Poland. But still, my friends, we are not going to yield at all. In fact, we're going to probably boost our numbers here in the east here, on the eastern front. Start to look possibly pushing down into Austria. That would be a boon for us if we could take Austria out. But look at Venice here, look around Venice here. That was just going to be an absolute... Mind you, if we were to take out Prague and Vienna, that would bring the collapse of the Austrians, and none of these forces would be involved at all. But that would risk... That would mean we'd have to move between these forces here that are arrayed here in Prussia, and that would be quite a daring move, but it might be something you might consider. I think what we will do is we'll move our spy as well down to here. Let's have a look what is down in Vienna. Good grief. Look, oh my goodness me, look what the Germans have got here in terms of forces. A huge amount. But my friends, hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, please comment, like, and subscribe. As always, keep your comments coming down below. And I really mean please, my friends, please keep your comments coming down below. They've been absolutely exemplary. Again, there are two general positions opening here. One on the Eastern Front in Europe and one in the Americas. Please let me know. I will choose a new general the next time around, my friends. We've got no fighting going on at the moment. Everything is calm here on the Eastern Front. So there will be two brand new generals who'll be taking over those armies. Let me know which one of you wants that. But until next time, my friends, hope you're having a good start to your week. Whatever you do, please be careful. But until next time, my friends, bye for now.